So you heard about some sweet trails north of Lake Pleasant in the Northwest Phoenix metro area, and you heard that some of them have interesting points of historical interest, like this place called the Old China Dam and Tule Homestead. But you're worried that the barrier to entry is high, and you might require four-wheel drive and some high clearance. Well, if you're worried about the last things, let's just get that out of the way now. Our recommendation is that if you're driving around back there, you should have all-terrain tires, four-wheel drive, and decent clearance. Our opinion, and the safe play. But if you're up for the challenges, which are moderate, the rewards are many and well worth the trip. Welcome to the official Cactus Atlas trail guide for the Old China Dam and Tule Homestead. This video will prepare you for a safe trip out to see some of Arizona's hard-to-reach history. If you want to follow along with our plan, we use a popular app named OnX Off-Road to create our mission plan. It makes navigating the maze of off-road trails north of Lake Pleasant simple and safe. We'll put a link in the description in case you want to check it out. Okay, let's head into our mission planning. Welcome to Mission Planning. Here's an overview of today's area of interest. Today's trails will take us through some thick patches of Sonoran Desert in the area north of Lake Pleasant. This area has lots of crisscrossing roads, and it's easy to get off course, and it's remote to boot. So knowing where we're going is of paramount importance. Using OnX Off-Road, you can see a custom route we created that will follow for today's excursion. The length of our route, including the short spur we will take down to the dam, is 8.1 miles, which ends at the homestead. Then we'll head out the way we came. If we skip the spur on the way back, it's 6.5 miles to the main road. Total trip is around 14.6 miles. There are two historical points of interest we'll mark on the map. The first are the remains of an old dam, which we can clearly see on satellite view. The next, and also as far as we are able to drive, are the remains of an old homestead. We can also clearly see that structure on satellite view too. As always, it sure would be nice to be able to use our drone to survey the area and historic structures. So let's first take a look at Sky Vector to see what type of airspace is back there. This one is a little trickier than some, because we are close to some wilderness areas, but based on our estimation, this is the area we want to fly in, which does not require authorization. Now, I'll show you a handy way that we use OnX to verify this. Looking at the map on OnX, you can see the two wilderness areas that we're concerned with. The blue line is our route, well outside of those two areas of concern. Now, the last thing we like to do is to click on the various land parcels to see who owns them, in case there are additional drone restrictions imposed. As is not uncommon in Arizona, where we have a lot of public land, much of our route, as well as the historical points of interest, lie within BLM land, so all good there. You might also see this other type of land called Arizona State Trust Land, restricted access. What that's about is if you plan to participate in recreational activities within those boundaries, you just need a permit, which is cheap and easy to get online. We'll put a link in the description where you can purchase and get any questions answered. As for us, we should be clear for takeoff anywhere along our route today should we choose. Final thing we like to do is read other OnX users' trail reports to learn about any specific hazards on a given route. Here you can see a report about a wash where there is a ledge of about a foot to foot and a half requiring enough clearance to climb. I'll mark the location of where I think it is so we can keep an eye out later. Last thing to note by studying the elevation graph is to expect a couple steep descents in and out of washes, especially the two spots we'll descend into Humbug Creek. All right, Buckaroo, hopefully you got all that because it's now time to execute the plan. Let's assume we all made it to the starting point. Here's the coordinates. It's on you to get to this point, but we'll guide you in detail from here. The first segment we'll tackle is the ride down to the Old China Dam. To get there, from the starting line, just follow the dirt road and enjoy the Sonoran Desert views and relatively smooth roads while you can. At about 1.2 miles in, hang a left. This is where to turn to access one of the best places to explore the old dam. You'll notice this short spur is a little rough and has a little bit of elevation to it, just like the elevation graph prepared us for. We found it easily doable in our stock 4x4, and the road's bark was worse than its bite. The prize for going this way is being able to park your vehicle on top of a backfilled part of the dam, which is a cool photo op. It's also the perfect spot to launch out on foot to explore the area, and the stone dam, that's the main point of interest. When finished, the easiest thing to do is to drive back up the spur the way we came and reconnect with the main road. When you get back to the point where we turned onto that short diversion, hook back up with the main road all the way to the old homestead. One spot worthy of note is the crossing of Humbug Creek. The way down this time is a little more easy going than the spur, but as soon as you get to the other side, it's easy to get off course if you're not careful, as some trails run parallel to each other. When you get to what we'll call the Humbug Roundabout, just make sure to aim this way to stay on course. It's straightforward from there. The road is in pretty good shape a lot of the time. The rough spots are when you have to go in and out of washes. Those get a little bumpy at times. Shortly before we arrived at the homestead, we encountered that obstacle another user reported, the rock ledge, pretty much exactly as described. After studying it in person, we decided to climb it and made it up with no problems in our stock ZR2. If for some you second guess it when you see it in person and want to make a safe play, you're about a half mile from the homestead at this point, so it's not unreasonable to hike the road from there if need be. You'll eventually encounter a fence prohibiting motor vehicles from that point due to a riparian area. From where you'll park, it's only about 100 yards to the historic home. The way is easy, and keep an eye out to your left as you approach the home, as there's the grave of an old miner's dog you should stop and pay your respects at. Here's some shots of the homestead. And that's the trip out there. So what do you say? Think you got this? Congratulations. You've completed the guide and should now have the information needed to help conduct a safe mission to the Old China Dam and Tule Homestead. A helpful tip is that if you're in a Jeep or a 4x4 pickup like me, you're almost certainly in for a few desert pinstripes on this one, especially if you get off course. But you won't, since you paid good attention here, yes? Other users on OnX called this one moderately difficult, and we would agree, maybe shifting towards the more challenging end of moderate at times. It's a contender for one of our favorite rides in 2024, and an easy one to get done just about any old time in the Phoenix area. If you found this video helpful or entertaining, please comment below and let us know, and if you do, we'll make more. Please subscribe for more content like this, and keep an eye out for a full time lapse of today's route coming out a couple days from now. Thanks for watching today, and we'll see you on the next one.